Well, that brings us to our next point, though. The USA is getting so crappy that even hard left-wing politicians and elites are starting to sniff it out and to be able to basically say that it's happening. Now, I think a lot of these politicians and these people that are saying, or these celebrities and people that are saying this stuff now, are saying it because they're not trying to lose all of their audience by being entirely irrelevant, and they have to admit the pain of the people at some point. But we've been saying this stuff for a long time, that like the reason Joe Rogan left LA years ago was because everything is trash there. Mm-hmm. The whole entire city's turned into trash. Even Anomaly, one of the dudes that I follow, Anomaly. He left L.A. because of all that nonsense. So this isn't a new idea. But now James Corbyn, fancy James Corbyn, who, you know, got his wings by kissing the butt of everybody in Hollywood.
Leftist,
you know, so he got his wings leftist. By kissing everybody's butt because he's like the most passive person in the world. But I want you guys to see his interaction with Gavin Newsom real quick. OK, why don't you pull this up, Tina?
All right.
I feel like the place I moved to perhaps doesn't exist anymore.
Interesting.
Everywhere I go. When I'm picking up my kids at school gates, when I'm meeting friends, all these things, people are talking about crime rates in Los Angeles, the type of crime that's happening, where those crimes are happening, the manner in which those crimes are being carried out in this city.
Yep.
I think police feel frustrated by... many LAPD officers feel frustrated in the way that things are being done above their heads. What's your thoughts on that? I know you're not the mayor. Yeah. I know you're the governor. I know you're not the mayor, but...
470 cities, but, you know, this is second. I mean, one of the most spectacular cities in the world. And, look, I'm very sensitive to this as a former mayor.
Yeah.
And I deeply appreciate the point you're making. I can give you statistics that bear fruit to a more objective look. One being Texas has higher violent crime rates and property crime rates.
Sure, but that's not an answer.
No one
cares. That
isn't
an answer.
And that's why I'm not going to
give that. You can't just say, but it's bad everywhere.
That's why I'm not giving that. I said, because we're prone to do that.
You sort of did give that while not giving
it. But I wanted to make the point, because no one cares about statistics. They care about how they feel and what they're experiencing. And what you just expressed is being experienced by too many people, because it is the reality in cities all across, yes, this state and parts of this country. So you're absolutely right. We got to take responsibility for that. We've got to address the issue of these flash mob organized crime groups that are breaking in coordinated manners into stores. We got to address the street issues in this state. We got to address the issue of homelessness. We've got to address the issue of affordability. But the issue of crime needs to be addressed much more forcefully. We got to hold people accountable. We got to prosecute them. And no one can deny that reality. And I don't deny it and know this. We're not just sitting back passively. We're not waking up to this. We're doing everything in our power as the state of California to support cities and county. I don't have a police force. We have the California Highway Patrol. It's not an excuse, though, to support those efforts to go after these rings and to get these bad guys and make sure they're prosecuted. So know that we are doubling down on all of these efforts. I take this very seriously, and I don't want you to turn your back on this city, and I don't want you to think its best days are behind it. They're not.
The best days are definitely behind it. And you know what's interesting? When James Corbyn says, like, the police officers are frustrated because they feel like there's stuff they can't control that's happening above their head, what they're specifically talking about is the district attorney that's funded by George Soros. The George Soros will put, you know, you'll have a district attorney race, which usually has, you know, let's just say $150,000 of campaign funds behind it. And he'll come into that campaign and he'll drop $3 million into one side so he can get the person he wants elected in that area. And then he'll tell them, don't prosecute certain crime, because he knows that if he can get that kind of crime to happen, it ruins the culture around it. So who did they bring in? Well, let's just look at it.
Right here. This is the DA.
George Gascon.
For LA, nearly 98% of Los Angeles prosecutors vote to recall Soros-backed district attorney.
And Gavin Newsom is acting like he doesn't know how this is happening. But,
exactly.
But let's look real quick. Who endorsed this fella to be able to come onto the scene? If you look at our other thing, Tina, pull this up. California Governor Gavin Newsom endorses the Joker that was funded by George Soros.
August.
We are doubling down. We are doing everything we can to take care of this stuff. 2020, homeboy's like, nah, get him in there. He's the trustworthy source. And they're going to BS. Look, we know the answer to this stuff. It's not like other cities haven't cleaned up the homeless population before. I was in LA in January. It's a train wreck. It is a train wreck.
What did you see?
I mean, it's like you have... sections where clearly people have decided to just go, this is now as if we were all living on the street permanently, and we'll make an ecosystem out of it. Thank you.